This is Teel with Teeltime and Pauline Smile. In this segment of Teeltime, we're going on a field trip. I'm going to talk about yoga, one of the great loves of mine. This coincides with my latest article in Health and Beauty on Pauline Smile, where I write about yoga. So now we're going to go to a studio and work on some poses. So before we do, time for a little nippers. A Patron, my friend, hopefully someday my sponsor, Patron Tequila, delicious. Okay, see you in the yoga room. All right, hi everybody, so here we are at the yoga studio, and I'm going to walk you through a few postures, Hatha yoga postures, that you can do on your own at home. And out of sequence if you want, and they will help you with restoration, with your sleep, with energy if you want to do them in the morning, or you can do them before bed. They're natural ranges of motion. There's nothing advanced about these postures. So here we go. My dear friend Jenn Chandler is going to help me, this cutie pie right here. So we're going to start with half moon pose. Toes and heels together, arms over your head sideways. Interlock your fingers, release your index fingers, and cross your thumbs. And squeeze your palms all the way to the wrist. There's no gap between her biceps, arms, and ears. Her hips are slightly forward, and the maximum weight is in her heels. Take a deep breath, full lungs, stretch up, and bend your body to the right without bending your elbows or your knees. So as you can see, and stop right there, she's breathing normally. She's, bring your right shoulder forward, so she's lined up. Her two shoulders are stacked. Her two hips are in alignment. Left hip forward, right shoulder forward. So she's moving in that coronal plane where she's like between two panes of glass. She's getting a nice stretch, this half moon shape, Ardha Chandrasana, on the left side with some compression on the right side. She's stretching her intercostals, her serratus, her obliques, and she's getting a compression here. It's helping her organs. It's strengthening her butt and her legs, and she's breathing normally. Inhale, breathing, come up, stop in the middle. Let's do the other side to balance her out. Stretch up, touch the ceiling, and bend your body to the left and push your hips to the right. So again, she's getting the nice stretch. Ardha Chandrasana, half moon. She's getting the nice stretch on the right side, compression on the left. It's good for your organs. Her right hip is forward, her left shoulder is forward. Everything's in line. She's in that coronal plane, and she's breathing normally. You're always breathing normally throughout all of the postures. Once your breath stops, the posture is over. Inhale, breathing, come up and stop in the middle. Now she's going to do separate leg stretching posture, Dandayamana Vibhaktapada Janya Sirasana. Arms over your head, palms together, thumbs crossed, and take a 3-foot step. And so her heels are in one line. You always want to make sure that you're in alignment from your feet all the way to the top. Lift your toes, turn on your heels, and face the right side of the room. So now she's squeezing her right hip forward to get her two hips in one line. Her two heels are in one line. Her back toes are at a 45 degree angle. Her arms and head are together. We're working the endocrine system in this one. Chin to your chest, choke your throat. Chin to the chest always rounds the spine. Suck your stomach in always on a forward bend and round your spine all the way down and touch your exactly forehead to the knee. And if your forehead does not touch the knee in this one, you bend your knee. Forehead and knee must touch though to get the compression in the front side of the body and the extension in the back side of the body. So the benefits here, we're compressing the thyroid, the spleen, the liver, we're extending the adrenals on top of the kidneys, and we're stimulating the pituitary. This is all good for your endocrine system and boosting your metabolism. Shift the weight forward into your front leg, so that means her right hip will come down and the weight will come into her left leg. And now she's nice and in line here, and she has the nice round in her spine. Her stomach is sucked in extremely, and she's getting all the benefits of this posture. Inhale, breathing, and come up. Arms and head together. You always come out the exact opposite way you went in. Full extension. Nice. And turn to the front, toes and heels together. So now we're going to do tree pose. Tree pose, Tadasana, toes and heels together. This is a hip opener and a lateral extension of your knee. So right leg up, Grab your foot from the inside with your left hand and bring your heel as high onto your body as possible. You want it more medial than lateral. And be very careful of your right knee. Your right knee is going to go back. Eventually, her two knees will be in one line. And so she's opening up the pelvis. Standing leg is locked. Her spine is straight. Her two shoulders are in one line. Her two hips are in one line. Right hand in the middle of your sternum. Left hand in the namaskar. And if your foot slips, you don't get put your hand. You don't bring your other hand up. You don't hold your foot here. Do the duck butt thing where your butt is sticking out. No duck butt. You want your tailbone tucked under, and eventually two knees are in one line. Pretty posture. And this opens up your hips. It's good for your spine. It's good for your concentration. Right leg down. Toes and heels touch. All right, let's get on the floor and do a couple of floor poses. So we're going to do cobra pose, Bhujangasana. Chin out on the floor. Fingers and thumbs are together like glue, and your palms are flat. Your fingers are in line with the tops of your shoulders. Your baby fingers are in line with the deltoids, and you glue your palms down. Your legs are one leg, like a cobra. Your heels are together. Your feet are flat. Your butt is tight. We're really squeezing the glutes because we're going to create compression in the lumbar sacral spine. Shoulders down, elbows touching the body. Look up and inhale, breathing slowly, gently come up. Again, she's breathing normally in all the postures, breathing in through the nose and out through the nose. Elbows touch the body, your shoulders are down so your trapezius muscles are visible. It's not a push-up. She's using her lower body strength to create this compression here in the lumbar sacral spine. Chest up, come up, hold it, and breathe. Breathing in stillness. And slowly lower down. Beautiful. Now we're going to do half tortoise. Ardha Kurmasana. This is bringing high-speed blood to the brain, and we're getting a good spine stretch. So her knees are together, her feet are together, and her feet are flat. There's no gap underneath her feet. Arms over your head, palms together, thumbs are crossed. She's in prayer. Chin is away from her chest because we want a flat spine. Suck your stomach in, squeeze your knees and inner thighs, keep your hips on your heels, and stretch forward. Her forehead will touch, then her baby fingers will touch. Eventually, you'll be able to do that too. If your fingers touch first, that's fine. Stretch your arms forward, so just her pinky fingers are on the floor, the rest of her arms are in the air. Her forehead's touching the floor, her nose is grazing the floor. She has a nice flat spine. Stretch your arms forward, shoulder blades and scapula coming out of the body. We're bringing high-speed blood to the brain, just like we were standing on our head. Her hips are back on her heels. She's sucking her stomach in, getting as flat as she can, and getting this nice stretch in the spine, stretch in the hips, stretch in the ankles and the knees, and she's bringing blood to her brain, getting a natural facial. Suck your stomach and arms and head together, come out. Full extension, arms down. Nicely done. Let's do camel. Camel Ustrasana, deepest back bend. So your knees and feet are 6 inches apart. Bring your hands on your lower spine so they're on your sacrum, not up on your kidneys. Thumbs are on the outside, fingers pointing down. Take a full deep breath, push your hips, stomach, thighs forward, and drop your head back. Remember, once you drop your head back in a posture, you keep it back there. She's breathing normally, and this is her posture. Push your hips, stomach, thighs forward, keep your chest lifted. She's getting a backward bend and a front side extension. Excuse me, a little boob graze there, everybody. Now show the full expression of the posture. You can grab your heels if you're that flexible. Thumbs on the outside, fingers on the inside. Look how beautiful that is. She has that beautiful back bend, full extension in the front. Bring your hands to your lower spine. Push your hips forward, chest up, spine straight. Inhale, breathing, come up. She's breathing the whole time. So we never do this to grab the heels, show them what we don't do. We never drop our hips to grab the heels. Because then you don't have your back bend. You just lost your back bend. We never twist to grab the heels. Like that. Once you're in the backward bend, if you can organically reach down and grab a heel, then that's your posture. If you can't, keep your hands on your lower spine. Okay, now we're gonna do dead body pose. Your legs are straight, heels are together, toes fall open, arms straight, palms rotate up. You're in an anatomical position. And you're breathing, inhale, belly rises, exhale, belly falls. This is dead body pose. This is Savasana. This is your rest period. In Hatha yoga, we have Savasanas. And I'm going to lay down with her too. And Emily's going to walk around us And come closer, Emily, so I can say thank you, everyone, for watching Teeltime. Thank you, Jen, for helping me. Thank you, Emily, with the camera. Thank you, Bikram Yoga Fort Worth. And we'll see you again soon on Teeltime.